So guys, I have drained the oil in the video of the service. You will see how I showed you guys how to drain your oil. But I also noticed that my sump was actually leaking oil through on the side here. So what I'm doing now is I'm gonna be doing the sump gasket on my Golf. So you have to, if you are gonna be doing your sump gasket, then you have to actually loosen all these bolts along the side here. I'm showing you guys how to replace your sump gasket. If you were to look at your sump and you see that your sump is leaking around this area here, then your sump gasket is basically leaking through. So you will then have to do your sump gasket. So I have showed you guys in the video of how to do the service, how to loosen that bolt there. It's a 19mm spanner bolt that you just loosen and you let your oil run out. As you can see, my oil is still dripping a little bit, but I'm loosening my sump right now because I want to take the whole sump off so I can do the sump gasket. But as you can see right around, there is a T40 spline that you use to loosen right around your sump. I've already loosened most of the bolts. So I'm just gonna loosen this last two here. They're still in, these two. Once I got these two out, then I should be good. Then my old sump will come off, and then I'll replace the gasket. In the event, especially for the low riders, if you hit your sump and you hit your sump open and it leaks oil out, you have to replace your sump. This is exactly what you're gonna be doing. So you will have to drain your oil. You'll have to loosen the splines here, T40 splines. And once you've loosened all these splines here, then your whole sump will then come down. The nice part of actually taking your sump out is you can actually clean your sump. You'll see there's some particles, sometimes look like little sand particles, that it will be sitting in your sump, and that you can clean out nicely before you actually put your oil back in. And then you know your engine don't have no sand particles or anything that is not supposed to be there. So that's basically the idea. Yeah. Loosen your sump there. So I loosen all 20 splines, which is a T40 spline. This is a spanner that you need to use just by hand. Tighten it and loosen it by hand. Otherwise, you're gonna mess your gasket up there. So you just tighten it with your hand and you loosen it with a spanner. It's a T40 spline. So I've loosened all 40 splines, but now what I have to loosen is these bolts here. This is 11mm spanner right there, and as well as this one here, also 11mm spanner right there. So once I loosen that too, then the sump will come out. But don't try to force your sump out when it's like this here, otherwise you will damage something here. So just loosen those two bolts and let your sump come out nicely. And then when you put it back in, you're gonna put it in and then you fasten this plate here. There. And then you don't have any hassles when you're removing your sump. So key thing here is not to pull the sump out here thinking all your splines is loose. Loosen these two bolts there. And then your sump will come out easily. So guys, after I've removed that plate here with the two 11mm bolts right here, I actually saw that here is another spline here. So you have to remove that plate, and then you can get to the spline here, which is the last spline on your sump. And once you have loosened this one, then your whole sump is then gonna come loose easily.
but never ever force your thumb. Always try to look if you loosened every single bolt before you try to take it out, because sometimes you think you took out all the bolts and there's one hidden bolt. And then okay, that one is out. Oh, there's another one. See, that's what I'm talking about. So there's another one there, right here. I don't know if you guys can see that there. It's actually two. One there that I am busy loosening. So that there, somewhat tight, but yeah, it'll come loose. There's it. Right, then you just balance the sump with your hands so the whole sump don't fall on your head. You know, injure yourself. But yeah, and once you loosen that to there, then there we go. And box your uncle. And there you go. And your sump will come right out like that. And you will then notice on the inside of your sump, your oil pump sits right here on the inside of your sump. So yeah, you can see that your oil pump there runs on the inside of your sump. So what I'm gonna do real quick right now, I'm gonna clean this whole part, just wipe off wherever I can. But essentially, I just wanna have a whole area looking nice and clean here around. And then I'm gonna clean the sump and I'm gonna replace the gasket. But I'll show you guys how to replace the gasket.
Here is my gasket, it is removed. So that's how it looks on the inside after I just took it out. What I have seen, here's a little stone inside, not good. Yeah, but then because I used engine flush, you can see that it's my oil is really, really thin. And if you do use engine flush, never drive with your engine too far. Never drive more than 10 minutes with your oil being so thin, because you can hit a bearing knock if you do that. So just be careful when you do engine flush. Throw the engine flush in right around the block a little bit fast, rev your engine up so it works through the engine, and then you come and you park the car and then you loosen your bolt right there for your oil to run out. So this is the old gasket that was here. We're gonna be replacing this with the new gasket. Gonna clean this thing nicely, clean it, and then we're gonna put this quickly back in. Right, guys, I have cleaned my sump. You can see on the inside there a couple of knocks. Yeah, it's still strong enough to take a good couple of knocks, I hope. I've cleaned it inside, outside, more or less brought it to a point. You can see my sump has been taking a good couple of scratches, couple of knocks, but I'm hoping that it can still last for a while. Yeah, so especially for us low riders, we get a problem with eating our sump. So yeah, if you do eat your sump and you break your sump, this will be the procedure to replace it. You can actually go and buy a new sump, or if you want to, you can actually weld this. Whatever part is broken, you can weld it closed again. Yeah, but a new sump would be the best way. I've got a sump gasket here. I actually bought this gasket for like 25 rand, and then I got this glue here. This is basically the glue I'm gonna be using for the gasket. Apparently it's very strong. Yeah, so let's try it out and then we're gonna quickly just apply to the surface here. So I've cleaned the surface very nicely, so I'm gonna apply some of this gasket glue here on the surface here, and then I'm gonna put my gasket on there on top, and then I'm gonna put a little bit glue on top of the gasket and run it across. And once I'm done, I'll take my gasket, take it right back there where I've taken it out under my engine, and we're gonna tighten it up. I'll show you guys how to tighten it up as well. But make sure when you take the nice part about this here is that you can
clean your sump nicely. If there was anything, I got a little stone here inside, anything that was not supposed to be in your sump, you can actually clean it nicely out and then put a gasket on and put it back in. So when you throw your new oil in, then you know there's nothing that's not supposed to be there. It's actually pure clean oil. And then all you have to do is maintain your service every 15,000 kilometers. I have applied my glue, my gasket maker, gasket glue. I've actually applied it here underneath my gasket. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna apply a little bit on top here, right around the surface, and then while it's still a little bit wet, I'm gonna quickly go and start bolting it fast, fastening it with my T20 T40 spline, and then yeah, then I should be good to actually start doing throwing my oil back in here. But I just want to give it like maybe 5-10 minutes for this to set. So once this has set, then I'm just gonna quickly give it a quick run of gasket glue or gasket maker across here, and then I'm gonna tighten it quickly while it's still a little bit wet, so that it can pull and create a kind of a gasket to seal it off, seal off your sump right around. So guys, as you can see right here, I have wiped the surface here where my sump is gonna come, just so that my sump glue actually sticks here. It's too oily, or if there's a lot of oil, chances are your sump glue will not stick. If you have sandpaper, you can sand it down a little bit if it's really dirty. My surface is not that dirty. I'm literally just wiping it with the rag down just to make sure that my glue can sit fast here once I tighten him up. Put you guys on the time lapse quickly, show you guys exactly how to tighten your sump. So guys, here is my old sump bolt. You can see it's a bit worn out there, but I can still use it, because what I'm realizing, I actually got another second hand bolt from one of my friends. Actually just gave me these bolts. It's not too bad when you look at it there, but if I look at this length, it's a bit shorter than my one, and I don't want to be actually messing around and then you find that the thing leaks. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna install this one, my old one, in back in on the sump, and then next time when I do the service, I must just make sure that I get the long sump bolt. You can actually buy them new, and then once I got that there, and then I'm good. I just don't want to take the risk to go with this one, then throw my oil in and then it leaks. For now, this could work. I just don't want to take the risk, so I'm gonna take my one and put it back. And then next time, I'm gonna use a new one, and I'll actually get a new one with the longer bolt.